What is Section 8 housing? If you're new to real estate investing, this is something you need to know. That's today's show. Let's dive into it. Hey everyone, I'm Clayton Morris.
I'm Natalie Morris.
We're longtime real estate investors, and we've rented to a lot of Section 8 tenants over the years. But a common question we get, common threads and otherwise, around the water cooler. Do we even have a water cooler?
No, we do not.
Well, if we got to get ourselves a water cooler because we can probably get a lot more questions that way. People want to know, what in the world is Section 8? Should I rent to them? What is it? How do I understand it? Should I be scared of it? There's a lot of things floating around out there. There's a lot of misinformation, I guess, around Section 8 housing.
Right? Is there?
There is. I think there's a lot of people that get scared about it. So that's not what this video is all about today. Today, we're just going to break down just the basics, the 101 about what Section 8 is all about. Okay?
Okay. We'll do that.
All right.
Section 8 is the common term for the housing assistance program. So it's the government qualifying people as low-income tenants, and they help pay the rent. So the way this usually works is that you go to the government and say, I need a little extra help to live in this area where I work and have my kids go to school. And they look at your finances and they say, yes, you're a hardworking person, but it does seem like you can't quite make rents in this area. And they certify you as a Section 8 tenant. Then you go out and find your own apartment or house or whatever it is you want to rent. I don't think they do it with a boat. I think it has to be a house. And
might be a houseboat. I wonder if in Seattle.
I don't think they do that. Because a houseboat actually is regulated by the DMV.
Just like a mobile home.
Right. I'm pretty sure that's the case. Right. Don't quote me on that. Okay, let's say that I have qualified as a Section 8 tenant. I go and find a house. You're the landlord. Mm-hmm. And you say, okay, yes, I will accept a Section 8 tenant. And so that means you set the rate of the house that you're going to rent, right? Let's say you say it's $500 and I have qualified for $400 of rental income assistance. So that means that the government is going to pay you, Clayton, the tenant, the landlord, $400 a month. And me, Natalie, the tenant, will have to come up with the extra $100. That's not always the case. Sometimes the amount of the rent is fully covered by the government. It just depends. But what it essentially means is the government has said, I commit to you, Natalie, that I will pay your rental rates or your housing, right, up to this amount.
Right. And so you have to prove a certain standard that you are working towards paying that other portion of the amount that the government is not going to pick up. You also have to find a house that qualifies for it. So you can't go to the government and say, hey, this $1 million house over here, like I need to live in that one. Could you live in an apartment that is better suited for your current circumstances? And so they'll look at those things and they'll look at the fair market value and make sure that the rent is consistent with the neighborhood as well. So, right. You know, you're in a typical neighborhood where you need to work. You can go and find a rent for $500 a month. And if there's an oddball property that's got a pool and who knows what's inside of it and they're charging $1,200 a month in rent, chances are you're not going to qualify for that $1,200 a month program in that particular property because they'll see it as inflated rent.
Well, the Housing and Urban Development Department, right, they're sort of certifying two pieces of a puzzle to fit together here. Mm-hmm. So they're certifying me, Natalie, the tenant, and my ability to continue to be certified as someone who gets Section 8 help. And you, Clayton, the landlord, as someone who will then take care of me, Natalie, the tenant, right? So you can't say, oh, awesome, Section 8 tenant, the government's paying for all of this rent, so then I don't have to take care of your house. That's absolutely not true. You have to meet certain standards. We're going to talk about that in the next video. But the government is making sure that both sides do their part, and you are then both parties responsible to this.
Right. So there's certain thresholds you have to meet. In some circumstances, I know with a couple of properties we've owned where the tenants had to reach, they had to pay up to 28.5% of their the rent amount. So you have 100% pie. They had to come up with 28.5%. The government paid the other balance. Okay. And then, but they had to come in and certify the property, which we'll get into, as Natalie mentioned, in another episode. But they need to look at all of that before they certify. So it can, and they, you could have tenants that will pay up to 75% or 80% of the value of that rent. and sometimes even lower than that. It really just depends on your current circumstance and how the Housing and Urban Development Department decides that you qualify.
And now I want to say, this is not the only government assistance program for rent. Section 8 is the most common, but we also have a tenant who has his rent paid through a Veterans Affairs Association. So there are various sort of ways that people can find assistance for rent. I think that's great. I'm happy to be a landlord who can provide a place for somebody to live who maybe doesn't have the same income earning potential. But you have to be the kind of person who says, okay, I'll jump through a couple of extra forms to fill out in order to rent to somebody who has these housing needs. We're going to talk about that again in the next video, but we wanted you to have a basic understanding. I do want to say before we move on to our next video, though, that these associations, either Urban Housing or the Veterans Affairs, they do pay. Like, it's a company now that's paying you instead of a person, and they pay on time. Our Section 8 tenant, their rent hits my account every month on the last day of the month without fail. So it can be both good and bad, and we're going to talk about that in the subsequent video.
All right, so this has been a video for investors looking to, you know, use Section 8. Maybe they will make some of their properties Section 8 properties. This is clearly not a video for you if you're applying for Section 8 status. You can obviously research ways online to be
as a tenant
to go and do that.
We want to talk about the investor side, clearly.
Yeah, so this is for investors, and we will have another video that will dive deeper into the pros and cons of that, how to work with different property management companies, how to work with the city, and all of that in an upcoming video. So for now, thank you so much for subscribing. We will see you in the next episode, everyone. Thanks so much. Now go out there, take action, become a real estate investor, because we believe it's the number one way to build wealth. We'll see you next time.